Me gusta porque está linda. Me gusta porque está bella. Me gusta demasiado bella. Me gusta. Ay, mi niña bonita, cosita chula, cosita bonita que dio papá. Así como está, así me gusta.
Me gusta.
Ay, me tiene loco, loquita, loco, mamá. No salgas a la calle
solita
porque está bien linda. Ven conmigo, mami, porque todo te puede vacilar, mamá.
What's up, you guys? How you doing? Yeah, good decision, that lady. Had her kids all going and got it. Anyways, what's up, you guys? How are you all doing today? I woke up this morning like, oh, gonna ride my 66 today, and got on this bitch, warmed her up, checked the tire pressure, started it up real quick, and jumped up on this bitch. I must say, like always, it's such a fucking weird transition to go from sitting in a lazy boy recliner to like being hunched over like you're fucking getting raped in prison. Ooh. Go ahead and calm it on down there.
Yeah!
Reindeer antlers, I need to get that for my 66. Are you kidding me? Oh my god. Look at her stuffing her fucking fat ass face with a fucking Nutri-Grain bar. That Nutri-Grain bar ain't gonna do nothing for you, lady. So last night, I jumped on YouTube, thought I'd watch a video or two. I saw Yummy R6 was live in his video feed on his Google Hangouts, and I saw some cool dudes up in that bitch. So I was watching and commenting, and then they sent me an invite, and I was like, sure, why not? So I set up my microphone real quick, and then went ahead and joined and thought that was really cool. It's on Yummy R6's channels. I come in on the 2-hour mark. But I'm definitely wanting to do one of those again. I'm definitely, I was wanting to ask if I did one of them Google Hangouts like once a week, maybe if you guys like them a lot, maybe a couple of them a week, maybe more. Maybe I'll fucking do some early morning ones, drinking some coffee, fucking having like a little early morning chit chat. I don't know, but I thought it was pretty cool. Should definitely do some more of that. You know what I haven't done in a while? Is a MotoVlogger spotlight, and I'm gonna give this a random MotoVlogger spotlight. He don't even know I'm about to do this, but it's a dude that I love watching his videos so long now, and I just want to give him a MotoVlogger spotlight, and it's for a MotoVlogger. MotoVlogger is a very funny dude with an awesome ass sounding bike, and I think you all should check him out. And here's a commercial that I'm probably gonna rip off of his YouTube page. Here it is. If you enjoyed his MotoVlogger spotlight, go ahead and shoot over to his channel, link in the description down
below.
And go ahead and let him know Baker X fucking D-Rock sent you.
Yeah.
I gotta admit, it feels nice to have that. Fuel injected inline foe in between my legs again. Thank you. Man, I bet whoever invented fuel injection got his tip lit from all the ladies he drove around in his fuel injected car. Feeling never gets old right there. Man. And this bike, I forgot, it makes every car feel like they're driving as slow as a snail dragging his ass against the dirt. I don't even know where I'm going right now. I'm just fucking heading straight and gonna go wherever the road takes me. About a couple weeks ago, I ordered a coolant reservoir because mine had a fat hole in it and it was dripping all my coolant out. And like within an hour of riding every time, I'd like lose half of my radiator of coolant. So I finally found one of those from some guy in like Georgia or some shit. Ordered that real quick and then put that shit on. Now I'm not leaking coolant no more. So I'm pretty stoked about that. Go get this fucking shitty ass Arco gas. Just cause it's the only thing around here. Ooh. Can I please get 10 on that number that I forgot to look at? Oh, 12, yeah.
Yeah.
Well, looks like 10 doll hairs is gonna go ahead and fill her right the fuck up. That's what I like to see. All right, we went ahead and filled her up with some fresh sex juice. Oh yeah, look at this problem that's persisting now. I got a fucking little oil leak from one of my little gaskets that are loose and shit on here. So I fix one problem and another one happens right then and there. Doesn't surprise me. Road that borders the freeway. Let's race this car. Let's go ahead and take us a little moment to bask in this beautiful ambience. Yeah. And the sign right here says, "Vote Kaiser Ahmed for SB School Board." Go ahead, Kaiser Ahmed, whatever the fuck your name is. You know what I want to know? It's a pretty cool topic. I'd like to know about you guys, your guys' opinion on it. Just from the past couple years, look how large MotoVlogging has gotten. Like, we went from like, and this is way before I even started, but we went from like fucking 50 people, I think, under 50 people, to like thousands of channels within the matter of like a couple years. So my question to you is, how long do you think MotoVlogging will keep growing? Because I can tell from a lot of comments, a lot of you saying, "I'm gonna start MotoVlogging, getting a new bike soon, getting a Ninja 300, getting a 250. A lot of you like guys are loving them 250s and 300s. They're nice bikes though, don't get me wrong. I would recommend getting the 300 though if you can. It's nothing way more powerful than the 250. I mean, it is more powerful, but it's just a way smoother bike and it has a better feel. And I know that from riding space pods. Even though I know his is a little modded out and shit, but I thought that bike was a really clean bike for what it was. And it had some get up and go to it. Man, I need to take the dual sport out here. I think there's some fucking jumps built right there. That's cool. It is a jump. All the birds flying with me, they're like, 66, 66, 66. Man, that scenery looks like it could be a damn postcard. If I'm in love with my scenery as much as I am still after being fucking growing up in the city, I wonder how nice you guys would love it if you visited it here. I'm getting myself all lost in this bitch. But yeah, my prediction is that motovlogging will become like so big, it'll be like a TV damn channel. It'll be like, hello guys, and welcome to the MotoVlogging Network. And all the commercials will be like for action cameras and gear to wear and you know, all that good MotoVlogging material. Shit. Yeah, I need to go ahead and find my way out of here real quick. The street looks promising. I should go to the college campus and ask people where the classroom 201 is. I'm looking for 201 and yeah, 358. Teacher's name is Mr. Megusta. What the fuck is this guy doing? He's talking on his Bluetooth. I love how they call something that goes in your ear a Bluetooth. Why couldn't they call like a fucking blue ear? May not have that zing to the sound, but at least it goes with what you're talking about. Yeah, if I ever have the resources and opportunity, I want to start up my MotoVlogging network. And it'll be a network of nothing but MotoVloggers. No matter how big of a MotoVlogger you are, you could be first day MotoVlogger. We'll fucking broadcast you on that channel. You know, it'd be cool as fuck. Have a way, like a rating system to see what episode's next and shit by all the viewers. And whichever one gets the most likes and whatnot gets to be the next featured video. That'd be cool. That would be really cool indeed. God, I wanted to make a left right here, and it's the only damn street around here that's fucked up.
Yeah. Yeah.
Say what?
That cop's smart right there. He pulled over and parked to talk on his cell phone instead of being a dickhead that thinks he's above the law and talks on it while driving. Good for him, man. Good for him.
Yeah.
Let's go ahead and get us a little mansion hilltop view. We haven't done that in a minute. What's up, Goldwing guy? A lot of you guys like this guy's cars right here, I noticed in the comments. He's got some clean cars. A 370Z, a full-blown Chirino, GTS, twin cam 16. That thing is real clean. Got that little Miata, and in his garage I seen him one time building I think he has an RX-7 in his garage too. That guy's got all kinds of tuner cars. Look at that clean ass Mustang. Oh, there's a bike in the driveway. Oh man, I'm just in one of those moods where I'm like loving the view and shit and scenery. Sitting out front of her house. It's weird. This is like a fucking crazy big mansion, and inside of it, all that lives in there is like a bunch of a big Mexican family. It's crazy. You would think a millionaire would have to live in this thing, right? But
hell, maybe they won the lottery or something. And they're like, muy bueno, let's go ahead and build a mansion on the hilltop. Hey, I don't blame them. I would do the same thing. Look at this. Let's look at it. Look at it for a second. Just embrace it. And the weird thing, there's a guy that lives in that RV, and he's even got his little electric cord, you can see, coming out of it to the house. And it's like, guys, you have a fucking, you have a house with four balconies, God knows how many rooms and bathrooms, and you make this guy live in a damn RV? It's fucking weird. Last night, I heard some super loud bangs outside of my house, and I was like, what the fuck is that? So I turned on the police scanner real quick, and immediately got told, I heard on the police scanner, they said, we got a report of a 5150 crazy guy that is shooting a shotgun, and it was on my street, out of all places. But I didn't see what the resolution of all that was, or what happened, or if anyone got shot, or the dickhead was just like shooting in the air or some shit. But let's San Bernardino for you guys. If he was a 5150, I'm assuming he was probably sticking some watermelons on his back wall and drawing pictures of people's faces on them and blowing them away with a fucking shotgun, thinking that was okay. That's all the hubbub about. Light's green. Oh, you fucking dickhead. I'm about to get through this shit real quick. I'm gonna go to the front of this pack right here. Spark my cigarette and talk my phone up. Make me like, yeah!
Say what?
That one startled him a bit. Don't, no, no. No, no, no. You can go ahead and scoot your little cooch. Sorry, buddy, but fuck out the way. Well, guys, thank you for watching another edition of my MotoVlog adventures. If you enjoyed it, that is, don't forget to go ahead and hit the fuck out of that like button, and you guys have yourselves a fantastic day.